There were a lot of porky pies told at the referendum, especially by the Leave campaign. In fact, predominantly by the Leave campaign. For example, of course, the biggest one of all being that we would leave the EU politically, but we would remain, of course, in the single market and customs union. And as has been put forward time and time again, if the Leave campaign had seriously campaigned on the deal that we have now, it would never have gone through at all. They would have never got the amount of votes they did, because as we always talk about when we talk about this stuff, they ran a wide campaign as possible to try and attract as many votes. And as I keep on bringing it up every time we discuss this, you know, Daniel Hannan, the brain of Brexit, infamously said on live TV when a Remain person was being interviewed alongside him, said that, you know, a vote to leave would mean a vote to leave the single market and customs union. Turns out he was right. But Daniel Hannan, the guy who was, again, big in the Leave campaign, said, no, that's not what it means at all. You know, only a fool would leave the single market and customs union. And yet, here we are now. So, as always, before we do go jumping into this, because again, these are some interesting figures from the new ONS data to come out. Very, very worrying indeed, considering that apparently Brexit is costing us £1 million an hour. Yes, that's a lot of money to be losing per hour. So before we do go jumping into that, please do remember to hit that like, share and subscribe button. And of course, down below, there are links to my Patreon page, one optimization link called Buy Me Coffee, but where you can buy me coffee. And as always, there are the YouTube stuff down below, the YouTube subscriptions button. And of course, the new YouTube thank you button as well, where you get to leave a fancy little comment down below. Or it like makes your comment look a little bit more fancier. So thank you very much to all those people who help and support the channel that way. So let's go on into this, because these make for some very worrying data, almost certainly, to be reading about this. So this comes from City AM, the title of EU Membership versus Lost Trade. Forget extra NHS cash, Brexit costs Britain £173 million every week, or at least £1 million per hour. Remember the Brexit bus promise. We send the EU £350 million a week. Let's fund our NHS instead. Vote leave. The truth increasingly seems that quitting the European Union means that there is now £173 million a week less to spend on the NHS, according to calculations by recent ONS and the UK government data. So this is not just ONS data, this is UK government data as well. But of course, they won't believe it because, as we've said before many times, that ideologues, it's become a cult. And whenever something goes wrong in a cult, they just deny that there's anything happening at all. So weighing up the cost of EU membership versus EU exports since Brexit. Brexit has cost the UK £9 billion a year, or around £173 million a week, or about £250 million a day, and just over £1 million every single hour. The studying of the latest Office of National Statistics data comparing the UK government's annual contributions to the EU lost in EU exports by examining the data for 2018, the last year before the pre-Brexit preparations screwed the data. Then comparing, of course, the 2021 figures, it turns out that far from bringing in the £350 million a week to lavish on the NHS, the UK as a whole is now £9 billion worth out of pocket. The UK government was scheduled to pay at least £20 billion for its membership contribution to the EU in 2018. However, the UK did negotiate an annual rebate, officially known as the Fontainebleau Agreement, with at least £4.5 billion reduced to the cost to about £15.5 billion. Additionally, the £4.5 billion came in the form of a UK in credits for programmes such as the EU Agricultural Guarantee Fund and, of course, £2.2 billion of the European Regional Development Fund, of course, at £0.7 billion. Given these figures, the ONS said that the UK government's net contribution to the EU, that is, of course, the difference between the money it paid into the EU and, of course, the money it received, was $11 billion in 2018. Compared this to the loss of exports to the EU, the ONS said that the UK exports of the goods to the EU fell by at least $20 billion in 2021 compared with 2018, the last period of stable trade. Even if we subtract the true $11 billion cost of EU membership from 2018 for the $20 billion drop in EU export earnings, the UK PLC is still £9 billion poorer than it was in 2018. And of course, David Jenkins, the head of consumer research at the international transport firm Parker Hello, which carried out this research, said, in January of 2021 alone, the first month of Brexit, the value of goods and export to the European Union fell from $14.3 billion in the previous month to $7.8 billion, he stressed. Comparing the cost of EU membership trade to its lost trade, Britain is now considerably worse off post-Brexit, Jinx told City AM. He said that the Brexit Opportunities Minister Jacob Rees-Mogg back in February claimed that Brexit is already a success and that the evidence for Brexit has already caused trade drops is few and far between. If the Brexit Opportunities Minister actually wishes to retain any credibility with the business leaders that he is supposed to serve, he could do far worse than analysing the ongoing UK-EU trade problems and, of course, in particular, the Northern Ireland Trade Protocol, Jinx commented. So, you know, we keep on saying it every time, the numbers do not lie. You know, the numbers do not lie. They are there for everyone to see. They ain't going anywhere. And of course, this is just going to get even serious problems. I mean, you just look at those numbers. You know, £9 billion a year, £173 million a week, and £25 million a day, and £1 million every single hour. That is a lot of money to be losing. And again, if you're comparing it to a business as they were down at the bottom, you know, imagine the UK as a public, you know, as a PLC. That's not sustainable. You know, that is not a sustainable way, you know, to run a country. And again, if Boris Johnson, well, we know he's not serious about it, but if he was serious about, again, leveling up the country, you're now losing a whole lot of money that could be going into the government purse to help fund leveling up. So yeah, it was, you know, this isn't surprising at all in the least, but there you go. Once again, Brexit always delivering on its promises for abject failure. So as always, thank you very much for watching. Please do remember to hit that like, share, and subscribe button. And of course, down below there are links to my Patreon page and one donation link called Buy Me Coffee, where you can, well, buy me coffee. And as always, thank you very much for watching, and we'll see you all next time.